Irish Republicans have followed through on their threat to disrupt the Queen's historic first visit to the Republic. TENS Europe correspondent Brett Mason is in Dublin, where protesters have fought with police.
While the British and Irish governments have described Queen Elizabeth's first visit to Ireland as a moment in history, today on the streets of Dublin it was clear this was a moment not everyone here was proud of. A beaming Queen Elizabeth donned the national colour as she touched down on Irish soil. This, a controversial first visit, 100 years in the making. Three bomb scares in 24 hours couldn't stop the British monarch from visiting. She's the first to do so since her grandfather, King George V, made the same journey in 1911.
I think it's an extraordinary moment in Irish history, a phenomenal sign and signal of the success of the peace process, and absolutely the right moment.
But after the bitter and bloody fight for independence, for many, the Queen's $25 million visit proved the ultimate insult. Hundreds of protesters fought with police as they tried to tear down the steel barriers lining the streets their forefathers had fought to liberate. Flares and explosives were hurled at police. As officers moved in and arrested 21 people.
The security operation for this visit is the largest in Ireland's history. More than 10,000 police and troops line the streets, while these steel barriers stretch for kilometres.
For many, this is as close as they would get to the Queen's bulletin bomb-proof four-wheel drive.
She's not welcome here. Go home. The same way that the Iraqis have a right to protest against the American occupation, Irish people have a right to protest against the British occupation.
By actually coming out and protesting, what are you hoping they will achieve today?
I want to send a message. I want to say that I'm not welcoming her here. I think more people in Ireland, you know, should be doing the same thing.
As the Queen changed outfits to lay a wreath at Dublin's Garden of Remembrance, protesters released black balloons to disrupt the solemn service. Large parts of the capital will remain in lockdown as the Queen continues her four-day tour. In Dublin, Brett Mason, 10 News.